good to be able to praise Him.
Amen.
It's good to be able to glorify Him.
Amen.
Amen. I thank God for His many blessings. We do have children's church downstairs this morning. We have a nursery. You can take advantage of that if you'd like. Amen. Give them a minute. Oh, yes. Thank God there will be peace in the valley.
Amen.
There'll be peace in the valley one day. Amen. Thank God that they're with you. I'm looking forward to peace, aren't you?
Amen.
You know, you either praise God or you not praise God. The choice is yours.
Amen.
But I choose to praise the Lord.
Amen.
I want to praise Him with everything I've got because that's what we're to do. That's what the Lord says we're to do. We're to praise Him. Amen. And I thank God that we are. You got the Bible today. Turn over to Psalm 34. Psalm 34, verses 1 through 7. And those who can, well, let's stand in reverence and reading of God's Word. Psalm 34, beginning in verse number 1. You got your place, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together. I saw the Lord, and He heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto Him, and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him, and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear Him, and delivereth them. Praise God. All taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in Him. Oh, fear the Lord, ye His saints, for there is no want to them that fear Him. The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing.
Yes.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You this morning, Lord, for the reading of Your Word. We thank for each and every soul that's here. We pray, Father, that You'll just move in a mighty way, that we'll be attentive unto Your Word. Oh, this short time, Father, and God, we pray that we'll all soul here, that they be saved. Lord, we pray, Father, oh, Lord, to let the cares of this life and the things going on in this life, Lord, depart from our mind and let us focus on You. Let us focus on praising You and Your Word. And Lord, we're going to lift You up this morning. We're going to give You all the glory. In Jesus' wonderful and holy name I pray. Amen. Lord, you sit down, throw them on beside you, and let them know you're glad they're here this morning. Praise God. We can either choose to praise the Lord and walk in the path of praise. Amen. Or we can walk in the avenue of the average. So many people are walking the avenue of the average. They stop praising God. They stop worshiping God. Amen. And my wife stood and she praised God for answered prayers. I know that that took something for her because she doesn't like to stand up in front of a lot of people.
Bless the Lord.
But when the Lord tells you to do something, the Lord tells you to praise Him, you stand up and do it.
Amen. Amen.
Him with everything that we have because we should be praising God personally. Praising God is a personal thing, isn't it? We need to praise Him. We need to offer up the thanks of praise, the sacrifice of praise. What? With our lips. We need to give Him the glory. Amen. In everything. Because God, amen, He is worthy to be praised and nobody else can do it for you. The one sitting beside you is not going to praise God for you. The one sitting behind you in front of you is not going to praise God for you. You have to do it for you.
Amen.
Amen. You are doing it for Him because God is worthy to be praised this morning. He's always worthy. Thank God. Amen. We see, amen, God is not looking at us in our praise corporately. He's looking at you. He sees our praise. But He also sees you.
Amen.
God sees us individually, doesn't He?
Yeah.
He sees us. He knows your heart this morning. He knows if you're lost. He knows if you're saved. Amen. And thank God you do too. Amen. Because there is power in praise. You can say pop or you can say pit. Power in praise, the power of praise. But when you start to praise and the praises go up, the blessings will come down. When the praises go up, your problems will smaller. When the praises go up, amen, you begin to see how great God is. so many times. We give people the praise and, oh, well, it would have worked out that way anyway. Well, maybe it would, maybe it wouldn't have, but God was in control. Amen. We're to praise Him, amen. Because, oh, whether things work out bad or whether they work out good, we praise Him in the good, we praise Him in the bad. Because He's God in the good time, He's God in the bad time. Amen. 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 God is always God. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I will give thanks. I will bless the Lord at all times. It's not always easy to give God praise when things aren't going your way, is it? Amen. But He tells us to praise Him anyway. Amen. When things are good, when things are bad, you begin to see how things get good when you start to praise Him. Amen. But so many people have stopped praising. Amen. When they stand up here and sing, Brooke sits up here and sings, Levi, Planet Grove, whoever else is singing, amen, we're praising God.
Amen.
Amen. It's not the music. If it's lifting up the Lord, amen, praise God, you better be lifting up holy hands, amen, on the Lord, because He wants us to lift up holy hands, amen. In 1 Timothy 2 and 8, I would that men what? Lift up holy and pray everywhere, lifting up holy hands without wrath or doubting. Amen. We are to lift up holy hands unto the Lord. Everybody lift up your hands, okay? Amen. You look at that. Look how many hands are lifted unto the Lord. We are to lift up holy hands. And so many times, we won't even stand up. We won't get up. We just take everything and, you know, that's just the way it is. Well, God wants us to lift holy hands unto Him and praise and worship Him. But many times, we don't praise Him. We don't give Him the glory that's due His wonderful name because He loved you so much. He sent His Son to die on the cross for you. Amen. Oh, isn't it so good to know that He did that? Amen. We praise Him personally. We praise Him verbally. Amen. Oh, we see He wants us to praise Him. Amen. We see as a Pentecostal church, He wants to hear from God's people. He wants us to praise Him. Amen. He wants, oh, He loves to hear praise. Oh, does He have to have your praise? No, God's God, whether you praise Him or not. Amen. But you should be praising. Amen. Because He is worthy to be praised. When you start to praise, your fear's going to run. Who in here has ever been afraid? Amen. I've been watching this thing on TV. It's just a commercial. But I read the book many years ago called It. I can't believe you read it. Well, man, I'm telling you what. Back in 1986, that movie came out. I actually, Ben and Amber watched it on TV the other night. Yeah, I got the TV. I got three. Amen. We watched it, and I was thinking, man, that movie was scary when I was a kid. You know, 86, you know, I was still young. Well, I'm still young now, don't get me wrong. In 86, I was younger. Amen. And I thought that was scary. And we watched that thing. I was like, yeah. That ain't that scary. You know, I saw all the graphics and things, like the flooring thing coming up out of the drain. I'm like, man, that looks fake. But I remember in 86, that was, ooh. And now, I watched a commercial of the new one coming out. And man, the commercial scares me. It does. It's a clown. And he looks like the devil. I'm telling you what, he'll stick with you. Just a commercial. I've been turning my eyes, I don't even want to see that thing, man. I have nightmares. Amen. You see, they've come a long ways in special effects and things. And there's no doubt they're going to add on to that story that was written. The book's about that thick, if you've ever read it. Amen. And, oh, it is scary. But we see how this new movie is going to be even scarier. It won't be like the one back in 86. It had John Boy in it and a whole bunch of other people. These kids would never remember. But we see how things have changed. How the things that we watch on TV and the things that we listen to and the things, amen, that we are enticed by. Amen. Amen. Have become so much more in your face. Amen. So much more. Yeah. Amen. We see how people like, how many of you like to be scared? I didn't think. I mean, I don't like to be afraid. How many of you like to live in fear? I don't think anyone likes to live in fear. How many of you have ever lived in fear? Amen. When you begin to praise God, your fears will go away.
Amen.
If the devil is standing outside your house and his imps, you think it can't happen, spirits and demons are real. Amen. You start to praise God, they don't want to be in the presence of him. Amen. They'll flee. Praise God. Sometimes you can be sitting at home and you know there's evil spirits around you. You know there's things lurking outside. Amen. Maybe real or just maybe demons out there. You know it. Amen. But oh, greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. And the devil's got no power unless you give it to him. Amen. Don't forget his power. Fears will run when you begin to praise God. God, I'm glad you're protecting me. God, I'm glad you're here with me. God, I'm so glad, because God doesn't want us to be afraid. Amen. We are afraid many times of things that we don't need to be afraid of. Amen. Like that movie. That movie ain't nothing but a man-made thing. Amen. Amen. We're afraid. We're afraid. But the Word of God tells us, amen. Fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. Who are we to fear? We're to fear the Lord. Amen. Where's the beginning of wisdom? The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Amen. When we fear God, he is the only one we should have a reverent fear of. Because God has gave you today. You may not have tomorrow. God has gave you the breath you have in your lungs now. You may not have the next one. Amen. There's people in here, no doubt, that struggle for breath more than others. Everybody take a deep breath. Oh, boy. Some people that was easy for. Some people they had to work for. Boy, that's one of my biggest fears, is smothering to death. Anybody ever have a fear of smothering to death? Or drowning? Not being able to breathe? Oh, my. Getting burned up is right at the top of the list, but you know what? I don't have to worry about burning.
Amen.
Amen. Because I know the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God, I'm not going to spend eternity in hell burning.
Amen.
Amen. But oh, suffocation is scary. I've watched people get 20 milliliters, as much oxygen as they could possibly push into your lungs, amen, and still didn't help them a bit. It's a sad thing to watch. It's scary to watch. Amen. It would be even more scary to be the one that couldn't get anything out of it. That's why a lot of people, they're afraid of the Lord. They're afraid of what God has done for them. When he breathes into you, you better inhale. When God breathes into you, you should inhale. When God breathes the word into you, you should take it in deep.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. I'm glad you don't have to be able to breathe real well to take the word of God in real well. You just have to be saved. Amen.
Amen.
The word of God, it'll penetrate you. The word of God will get you. The word of God will change you. Amen. Thank God. Enemies will be defeated. When you begin to praise God, your enemies will be defeated. Who believes this? Amen. Your enemies will be defeated when you begin to praise. Because God, he loves the praises of his people. He inhabits the praises. He loves to hear us praise him. How many of you in here have got enemies? Every Christian in here, you got an enemy. Amen. You've got the devil. He is your enemy. Amen. We as a nation, we've got enemies, don't we? Amen. We've got a lot of enemies as a nation. Amen. But when we begin to praise God, enemies flee. Amen. The word of God is clear on that. We see Jehoshaphat over in 2 Chronicles 20. We see Jehoshaphat. Amen. And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that they should praise the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army, and to say, praise the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. And when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set ambushments against the children of Ammon, Moab, Mount Seir, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten. Amen. We see that people praising went out before the army. People praising went out towards the enemy. Amen. It didn't say they went out with guns and spears and knives. It says they went out with praise. Amen. And when they went out with praise, but we see a king named Jehoshaphat that he had... The Bible says he had set himself to seek the Lord. He knew they were coming up against an enemy that they could not beat. He knew he was greatly outnumbered. He knew there was no hope except in God. Amen. So he began to give praise. He had set his face to seek the Lord. That's what people need to do today that are facing an enemy that seems like it can't be beaten. And you need to set your face to seek the Lord. because they were praising. They were seeking the Lord. Amen. And when the Lord invites you out, you better bet you're going to win.
Amen.
Amen. When he's fighting you out, he's going to win. You try to do it on your own, you're not going to do so well. Amen. But when you are fighting him with the Lord, when you're praising him, when you set yourself to seek the Lord as Jehoshaphat had did, amen, God will move on your behalf. He will move into the situation. Amen. And that goes on to say they went out among the bodies and they gathered enough spoil or enough gold and loot, amen, where they didn't lack anything. Shoot. God provides in a lot of ways, doesn't he? Amen. We've got victory, don't we? We're victorious when we praise God. We're victorious when we don't let the things of this life tear us down. We're victorious when we praise him in the middle of the storm. We're victorious, amen, because we know Jesus Christ, because we are more than conquerors, amen, through Christ. We are victorious. Amen. Some people are excited about being victorious. I know I am, but I don't want to be on the losing side. Amen. I want to be on the winning side. I want to have victory, and my victory is in Jesus. And the way that we win is through praise. Amen. Through prayer. Personal praise. Personal prayer. Amen. Oh. And we should be praising him verbally. Amen. We should be praising him physically. We should be praising him continually. Amen. We should praise him always. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. If we're going to boast in anything, we boast in the Lord. Amen. We're going to praise him continually. We're going to boast in the Lord. We have to be vigilant. Amen. We have to be vigilant. We have to, without a doubt. Amen. What vigilant? We have to seek the Lord. We have to be actively. To be vigilant at something means you're active at it. You're doing it. On your own. You ever hear of a vigilante? Well, they're doing it on their own. Amen. You be vigilant. Who else can praise God for you? You. Who else can seek God for you? You. I can pray for you, but I can't seek God for you. Amen. I can pray, but I can't seek him. You have to do the seeking. Amen. Oh, we see. Amen. We have to be vigilant. The Word of God even tells us, 1 Peter 5 and 8, to be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, you got an enemy. Remember, adversary. Amen. As a roaring lion, roaring about seeking whom he may devour. We have got an enemy. Amen. And we have to be vigilant. What does vigilant mean? Amen. To keep awake. To watch in the Greek. We said to keep awake. We've got to stay awake. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. When you're on guard duty, if you were ever in the military, you was on guard duty, you did not go to sleep. As soon as you do, the enemy's going to come up and sneak up on you and kill you.
Amen.
And worst of all, kill all those that you were supposed to be watching over. Amen. Oh, got to stay awake. Got to stay on guard. Amen. You have to. You've got to be watchful. Now, it's not always easy to be watchful, is it? It's easy to just say, oh, we're watchmen on the wall, Christian. We should be watching. We're watching out for these young people. Watching out for all those around you that are saved. We're watching. We are victorious. Remember that. But we have to stay vigilant. Amen. We have to. We've got to stay awake. Amen. Oh, we see the Word of God does instead. Clothe yourself with the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ and don't let yourselves think about ways to indulge your evil desires. Amen. We see when we put on the Lord Jesus Christ, amen, when we put on the Lord Jesus Christ, make not provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. We don't make provision for the flesh. We put on Christ. Amen. And we have to do that vigilantly. You woke up this morning and you chose to come to church. You chose to be here. Amen. I know the devil fought against you. I can do this, I can do that. It's going to be a perfect day. But you chose the best thing. You chose to come in and worship him. Amen. Because you know there are two natures beating within our breast. We have two natures. Amen. One is of God and one is of the flesh. Amen. We see that we're constantly in a battle, the flesh against the spirit against the flesh. We're in a battle. And let's say this is an old Cherokee proverb of two wolves. Amen, that are in us. If you don't feed one and you feed the other, which one is going to thrive? Which one is going to live more? Amen. The one you feed the most. That's true spiritually. Amen. You have the flesh battling inside of you, and you also have the spirit. Amen. Which one are you feeding the most? Are you feeding the flesh or the spirit? You couldn't be sitting here today starving to death spiritually. The only time you pray is when you need. So the only time you read the Word of God, amen, is when you, well, you may not ever even read the Word of God. You come to hear a preacher say it, you never crack the book again. Amen. You're hurting. You're not feeding the spirit. You're feeding the flesh. Because the devil doesn't want you to study. The devil doesn't want you to read the Word of God. But God wants you to study. Because the Word of God tells study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman needeth not be ashamed, rightly dividing the Word of truth. Rightly dividing. And if we study, amen, we're going to be feeding the Spirit. If we're praying, we're going to be feeding the Spirit. If we're fasting, we're going to be feeding the Spirit. If we're loyal to the house of God, we're going to be feeding the Spirit. If we love one another, like Jesus said, we're going to be feeding the Spirit. If we're not judgmental, we're going to be feeding the Spirit. Amen. But we become so judgmental so many times as Christians that we run people away. Who in here has been guilty? Other than the pastor. Amen. We see we become so judgmental. We've got to stop judging people.
Amen.
Amen. Boy, it's hard to do, isn't it? We judge people in under a second. You form an opinion the minute you see somebody. Unconsciously. But you form an opinion based on their looks, the way they're dressed, skin color. Amen. The area that they're from. Oh, my. See, we can't do that, Christian, because God says He is no respecter of persons. The last time I read the Word of God, it said in the beginning, He created. He created what? He created everything, didn't He? Amen. He created man, what? After His own image.
Amen.
Oh, my. It doesn't say white man, black man, Asian man, Latino. It doesn't say Spanish or Mexican. It doesn't say any of that, does it? It says man, mankind. Hello, who all is supposed to be saved? All. Mankind. It's not God's will that any should perish, but that all should come unto repentance. God doesn't want to see anyone go to hell. Amen. A lot of people's not like that. A lot of people, well, I pray death on them. Whoever prayed death on anybody? Don't raise your hand. Amen. It's not right, is it? God would not want, we can pray salvation, but not death. We can pray death on the devil. Lord, kill my enemy, the devil. That'd be the only context he'd be right in. Oh, wow. And we know he's going to in the end. He's going to cast him down, amen. Thank God. We see, amen, which one are you feeding the most? You've got to imagine the consequences of what you do. A lot of people like to blame their circumstances on everybody else.
Amen.
A lot of people like to blame the junk that they're in. Well, if mommy hadn't been like this, if daddy hadn't been like this, if granddaddy hadn't been like this, if, and after on and on and on, you are responsible for your own decisions.
Amen.
You are responsible for your own mistakes. Nobody made you do anything.
Amen.
You chose. Oh, boy, that ain't popular. You imagine the consequences of your actions. Every action produces a response. Amen. Every action, there's a reaction. Amen. You have to think about the consequences of sin that you may be choosing to live in. For the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. You see, look at that. God's given us a gift through Jesus. There's consequences for sin. Well, brother, you mean God's going to come? Sure, God's going to come down on you. You living in sin, you think God's going to wink at it? The Bible says He's not going to wink at it. The Bible says you will be held accountable. Not me. I'm accountable for what I preach out of the pulpit. Amen. I'm accountable for the Word of God. But you're accountable for your actions. You're accountable for the consequences. God is going to give you exactly what you deserve. Amen. We see in Ecclesiastes, the preacher tells us, the preacher who is Solomon, by the way, we see when a crime is not punished quickly, people feel it is safe to do wrong. Well, isn't that the truth? If every thief got their arm whacked off, they wouldn't steal much, would they? Woo-wee. If every murderer was put to death immediately, it wouldn't sit on death row for 30 years, would it? But see, the way our society's gotten messed up, when a crime is not punished quickly, people feel it's safe to do wrong. Isn't that the truth? If there's no punishment for the action, if your kids are out of control and your kids are throwing a fit, and oh, honey, it'll be all right. What do you think they're going to do next time? They're just going to keep throwing a fit. Amen. Amen. Well, mommy, let me do it. Or daddy, let me do it. Crime goes unpunished. If action goes unpunished, amen, people think it's okay. But even though a person sins 100 times and still lives a long time, I know that those who fear God will be better off. Oh, my. Isn't that good news? I know those who fear God will be better off. Because we many times we look at people that are sinning and living in sin, and we look at them, and Lord, when are you going to repay them? When are you going to get them? Don't worry about it. You worry about you. Amen. They may live a long time, but because you're fearing God, you're going to be better off than the wicked. Because you know what's coming in the end. Hell for the wicked. Heaven for those who trust Jesus Christ. Those who are living for the Lord. Oh, the wicked will not prosper, for they do not fear God. Their days will never grow long like the evening shadows. Amen. God has a good economy. God takes care of things. He said, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. I shall repay, not you. Amen. God will get vengeance on the wicked. Amen. So many people, they want to return evil with evil. Boy, that one talked bad about me. I'm going to talk bad about them. They put a story on Snapchat bad about me. I'm going to put two about them. Or Facebook or whatever you use. Amen. It applies. It does apply because people do it. But the Word of God says not to return evil with evil, but to return evil with good. How do you overcome evil? With good. You overcome evil with good. Somebody's putting you down and making fun of you and mocking you. Pray for them.
Amen.
Pray for them. Amen. Don't try to be worse than they are, because then you're the same as they are.
Amen.
Oh, my. We see, amen, how the Lord moves and how He works. Amen. And we know that God is in control. There's consequences to sin. Amen. We have to be vigilant. And we have to cry out to God. Amen. Cry out to God right now.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you. Boy, if it's you people. Oh, Lord, help me. Oh, Lord, we praise you and thank you today in the house of God. Amen. Let's all stand just 1 second. Amen. Let's stand. Let's just give God a little glory. Oh, Father, we give you praise. We thank you for letting the people come together today. Lord, we thank you for our family and the help, God, that you give us. We give you all the glory. We pray, Father. Same thing. He had acted like a madman back in 2 Samuel 20, somewhere like, I think, verse 10 through 21, somewhere in that area. And you see, amen, he had acted like a madman in front of him. Amen. He let himself start drooling and he started calling at the wall. He did all kinds of things that looked crazy and he didn't have anything to do with it. He said, send this madman away. Oh, but we see the psalmist here, he's praising God for delivering him out of the hands of his enemies. He's praising God, amen. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us extol his name together. Amen. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. Oh, when we seek the Lord, he will deliver us from all our fears. Whatever you're afraid of, it could be somebody, it could be something, it could be poverty, it could be maybe somebody at school, it could be a class that you're afraid of that you can't pass, or something you're afraid you can't do. It could be a sickness that is in your body. Amen. You could be afraid of that, but you cry out to God, he'll deliver you from all your fears. Amen. Amen. God is able to deliver you. Amen. Oh, thank God. We sir, keep going back. My wife offered up praises to God for answered prayers. Amen. You see, he's able. He's able to answer prayers. We give him praise when praise is due, and that's all the time. Whether it's good, whether it's bad, praise God. Amen. We're to praise him in all things. Amen. They looked unto him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him. Oh, my, cry out to God. That's what it took for all of us. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him. When the day you got saved, you cried out to God. Amen. Lord, save me, I'm a sinner. Lord, you may not have audibly said those words, but they were in your heart, and God knew your heart. Lord, save me, I'm lost. The day you come to an altar, the day you bowed in his presence, the day you just said, Lord, save me. I cried. This poor man cried. And the Lord heard him. The Lord hears your prayer. If you're saved or you want to be saved, the Lord hears your prayer. He does. And saved him out of all his trouble. He didn't save him out of some. He saved him out of all his trouble. Thank God. God's not a halfway God. Amen. Now, oh, you see, he's saved there. Also, he brought him through safely. He'll bring us through things safely. Things that we don't think we can get through. But the Lord will bring you through them safely. He will bring you through the storm that seems like your ship is going to turn over and capsize. But he will bring you to the other side and you'll step out on dry ground and have sure footing as long as you're trusting in him. You have to be trusting in the Lord. You have to cry out to him. He'll save you out of all your troubles. Amen. Oh, thank God that he will. Oh, we see. Amen. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him and deliver them. Amen. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him. Boy, that's good. You fear the Lord, you got an angel of the Lord encamped around about you.
Amen.
Isn't that good to know?
Amen.
Amen. You think God, angel watching over you, fear the Lord, the word of God says so.
Amen.
Angel of the Lord encamped around about you.
Yes.
Woo! Isn't that good?
Yes.
That's good stuff, man.
Yes.
Oh, we see how the Lord works. You call unto him, and I will answer thee and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. When you call on the Lord, he'll show you things. Amen. Things you don't know, great and mighty things. Oh, thank God we see that we've got, oh, here's a battle that you're fighting. Who's fighting a battle today of the two flesh, of the flesh and of the spirit? Amen. Every hand in here says, yep, because the word of God says we are. Amen. We've got two members in our body that's struggling, fighting against one another. We've got the flesh and we've got the spirit. We've got to take our thoughts into captivity.
Yes.
Oh, where's the battle started? Right here. When the word of God speaks of heart and mind, they're interchangeable. Because your heart and your mind are hooked together. The heart of man, where does it start? It starts right here. The center of your being.
Amen.
The battle is in your mind, isn't it?
Yes.
How many of you are fighting things in your mind right now? How many of you, the devil will put things in your mind that don't even exist?
Amen.
Amen. And you'll take it and run with it.
Amen.
Amen. And you'll go, oh, you're fighting a battle. You just, oh, you got to get your thought life right. When you get your heart right, your thoughts will begin to follow. You got to get your thoughts into captivity. Well, I'm going to think about all these other women. I'm going to think about all these other men, you women. I'm going to think about stealing. I'm going to think about this or that that's not of God. Amen. When you're thinking of things not of God, then your thought life is not right. You have to get your thoughts into captivity. Get them under control. Because our thoughts, our mind, who in here's mind runs wild? I can't hardly sleep. I get things on my mind. If I get 5 hours, I'm doing good. Because I get to thinking things, and I get to thinking, and I can't rest. Anybody know that's called anxiety? Amen. Anybody, you get to thinking, and what you got to do tomorrow, and tomorrow may never come, by the way. See, we get to thinking that we've always got tomorrow, but we don't know that we've got tomorrow. Today could be it. You got to get your thoughts right. You got to get your thought and your priorities. We get our priorities all out of whack. God should be at the top of the list. God, the Father, Son, Holy Ghost.
Yes, amen.
Your family.
Amen.
Amen. Your children. Oh, your wife. Your husband. The church. Amen. And you can list them however you want to. A lot of people got work. God. Fishing. A lot of people got their priorities out of whack. We got to get our thought lives captive. We got to be thinking on the things of God because He tells us to meditate on His Word. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal or made by hand, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down or suppressing imaginations, thoughts, and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. We can, through the power of Christ, bring our thoughts into captivity.
Yes.
You can't do it on your own. You can't do it without the Spirit of God. You can't do it without the Holy Ghost. You can't control your thoughts. But through the Spirit of God, you can. You can bring them into captivity. When you're concentrating on God and God alone, you can bring your thought life where it needs to be, on Him.
Amen.
Oh, if you get your thought life on Him, everything else is going to get better. When you're thinking on God and God alone, things are going to get better. You'll start to praise Him a little more. You'll start to give Him glory. Amen. And we know, we see victory being spelled out here. The omnipresence of God. God is everywhere. Is God right here? God's right here.
Amen.
Is God over here? Yep.
Amen.
Is God right here?
Amen.
God's everywhere. He's omnipresent. He's all over the world all at once. He's everywhere all at once. Throughout the galaxies, everywhere. God is everywhere.
Amen.
He is omnipresent. Amen. And He's omnipotent.
Yes.
He's all powerful.
Yes.
God is in complete control. Amen. Oh. Thou knowest my down sitting and my uprising. Thou understandest my thought afar off. God knows your weakness. He knows your strengths. Amen. He knows your thoughts. I wish that preacher would be quiet. He sure has been preaching a long time. Well, God knows what you're thinking. He knows your thoughts are not where they need to be. He knows you're not thinking about victory. Amen. We rely on the Scriptures. You don't rely on the preacher. You don't rely on Granny, Grandpa, Mom, and Daddy. You rely on the Scriptures, on the Word of God.
Amen.
You rely on the Word. Amen. Looking out the window don't do you any good. Look at the one beside. Look at the one beside. They don't do you any good. Relying on the Scriptures is what's going to benefit you. When you've got questions, you turn to God. When you've got questions, you go to His Word. When you want victory, you get into the Word of God. Because people will kick you down. People will bring you down. We were talking about toxic people in our lives in Sunday school. There are people in your life that are toxic, that keep you from God. You need to cut them off.
Amen.
Amen. If they're toxic to you, get rid of them.
Amen.
If they're keeping you out of the house of God, they're keeping you from following God, that's not of God. Because God will never lead you away from Him, always closer to Him. Amen. Oh, and we've got to rely on the Scriptures because He tells us, draw nigh unto me, unto Him, and He will draw nigh to you. You get closer to Him, He will get closer to you.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Oh, rely on the Scriptures. When you're in need, turn unto the Word of God. Thy Word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. You better hide His Word in your heart. You better have it in there. Amen. Because when a time you're out somewhere and it comes up and you need something, amen, rely on the Scripture. Rely on the Word of God to get you through it. Amen. Flip over to the book of Psalm. It'll help you a lot. Flip over, amen, into whatever book you feel is comforting. Amen. I love them all, but Psalm will bring you comfort.
Amen.
It'll address what you're going through in there somewhere. Read it all. Amen. Rely on the Scriptures. Hide His Word in your heart that you might not sin against Him. This book of law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night. You're to stay in it day and night in your thought of life. In your thoughts.
Amen.
Oh, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein, for then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success.
Amen.
Oh, we got to stay in that word. Amen. There's no, I don't care. There's no temptation. Who in here has been tempted this week? Amen. There has no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man. What everybody else goes through. But God is faithful. Say that with me.
God is faithful.
Who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able, but with the temptation also make a way of escape that you may be able to bear. He will make a way of escape that temptation. Amen. Amen. Think of your temptation right now. Think of it. Put your head right there. Go ahead. Help me. Think of your temptation, the one you struggle with. It didn't take that long. I know it before I even said it. Amen, didn't it? God already knew it too, didn't he? He makes a way of escape. How do I know that? The Word of God tells me so. But now you got to, life is like a maze. God makes a way to get out of it, but you got to choose. Everything comes down to your choice. You got to choose to take that way of escape. You got to choose. It could just be a simple no. It could be turn a channel. It could be not go somewhere. It could be this, that. Amen. He makes a way of escape. It takes you to choose it.
Amen.
Amen. You have to choose. Oh, we see victory. That's how we get victory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We get victory, amen, by being vigilant, by imagining the consequences of our sin and our actions, to cry out to God, to take our thoughts into captivity, to know God is everywhere. He's omnipresent. Rely on the Scriptures and yield to the Spirit.
Amen.
We've got to yield to the power of the Holy Ghost. If we don't yield to the Holy Ghost, there's something wrong. Amen. Your heart's not where it needs to be. For if you live after the flesh, you shall die. But if you through the Spirit do put to death or mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. Amen. The Spirit of God. Through the Spirit. That's how we're going to do it. Through the Spirit. Not through your strength, but through His strength.
Amen.
Musicians, if you'll come. Through His strength. That's how we're going to get to victory.
Amen.
Letting Him fight the battles. Letting Him squash all those fears. Because He tells us time and time again, be not afraid, for I am with thee. Be not afraid, it is I. Be not afraid. Be strong and of a good courage. Be not dismayed. Because He's going to go with us. He's walking with us. If you're saved, He's walking with you. You're part of the church if you're saved. I'm not talking about this. I'm talking about the church. Amen. Not Church of God. Amen. Because heaven's not going to be split up in the Church of God, Baptist, Presbyterian, Methodist, and all the other. It's going to be the church. Those that know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior.
Amen.
Let's all stand. I don't know every heart here today, but there's some here today that are not living a victorious life. There's some here today that are battling temptation. There's some here today that are struggling. There's some here today, amen, that are not considering the consequences of walking away from God. There's some that need to come and pray this morning. There's some that need to come to the Lord. If you're here this morning and you're lost, now's the time to come get saved. If you're here this morning and you don't know Jesus, now is the time to come to know Him. If the Holy Ghost is drawing you, it's time to be saved. If the Spirit of the Lord is saying you need to go to that altar and pray and get this under control, come and get it under control. If you need to have a thought life that's not where it needs to be, you need to come and get it under control. Amen. If you are not meditating, or if you're not on the Word, if you're not praying the way you should, you need to come and get help from God. Where did my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, who made the heavens and the earth. Amen. We need a help from Him. He's the only one that can help us. We all need help in here today. Everyone in here needs help. This Christian walk is going to be a hard one, but it is a good one. The payoff is out of this world. Woo! Thank God. You need to pray this morning. Come to this altar and pray. Whatever you're struggling with, whatever you're dealing with, if your relationship is in shambles, if your life is in shambles, if you just don't see any way for the victory to be possible, it's possible through Him. It's possible through Christ. Because the Word of God tells us, amen, that all things, I can do all things through Christ, which gives me strength. I can do all things. The devil will tell you you can't, but God tells you you can. Amen. Oh, well, they told me this test come back bad, this came back bad. Well, have you took it to God? Take it to God. God is the great physician. He is the healer. I pray, Father, for those that are in the pew, Lord, that are seeking you. I pray, Father, that you help them to be victorious, that you help them to overcome whatever it is they're fighting for. I pray, Father, that they'll draw closer to you. I pray, Father, that you would just move and work in every relationship in here today. That you would touch those that are struggling, Lord. That you would help them to see the way that you would help.